Thank you very much, Rich. Thank you, Phil. A good way to start the day. A little bit of a upset, I guess, if you look at the current standings coming in. But Epsilon, they do take the series, and they played very well, Joe.
Yeah, I mean, after the game, they were, you know, pretty pumped about it. Again, it's just a... They're in a position where all they can do is work on getting better, right? You have Reedy now. You have to go to relegation. You pretty much came to those terms a while ago, right, when you don't have many wins until this week. So the only thing you can focus on is improvement. And, you know, it looks like it's working so far.
Yeah, their improvement has been leaps and bounds, to be completely honest with you. Every time we kind of watch them play, you can see the way that they are improving. Obviously, Chance, myself, and you, we've had the privilege of casting them the past couple of days, and we've seen those improvements come through. But a big win for them. Of course, we will just recap that series very briefly, because I'm so, so excited for the remainder of the day. So, some massively, massively important games. Of course, game one, the hard point, Gibraltar, 250-223. And honestly, I mean, they kind of threw that one away, Chance.
Yeah, I think a big problem for them is tempting to rock the MP40. Like, we saw the success he had on the CTF London dock. So I think that should have been his go-to gun. Use that instead of the STG, pulled out a couple times. Maybe they're having some chem issues, because sometimes you see Classic as that flex player. Sometimes it's temp. So Envy, of course, things to work on for those guys as well. But I still think no issue with that series for them long term. They still look like a fantastic squad.
I think game two was summed up kind of perfectly after a little bit of, well, I don't want to say the word world star, but it didn't go well for Classic. It was funny because Temp reached over, was like, yo, fist bump, and Classic just completely ignored him. He's like, nope, not going to happen. But of course, Epsilon, they take the search and destroy as well.
Yeah, I mean, for Envy, you get out to a 4-1 lead, and you have to put those sorts of games away. Like, it's just one of those things where you have to be able to close, and you can't allow Epsilon. Yes, there was that round that sort of gave them some momentum, but that's a bit of a worry if you are an Envy fan, right?
Like, yeah.
You can't allow teams to take those sort of games away from you. You have the lead. You work hard up to that point, and then you just sort of let it all go.
Yeah, and then, of course, the game three, the CTF. This is where, even though they were 2-0 down, Envy do fight back 5-3, the final score, Chance. And, I mean, you can see there some of the stats. Reedy with a good game. Classic as well.
And how many times have we seen Envy just go down 2-0 in the series, right? It's happened time and time again. So when this map happened, in my mind, I'm thinking reverse sweep. Like, they're pulling out pocket strats. They're going as hard as they possibly can to make the comeback. Again, this is where we saw the MP40 come out from Temp, and we saw the success that he had with it. Maybe a couple rough games here and there, but I think the Doc CTF is where he really shined through as a player.
Yep, okay, fair enough. Then, of course, we go to game four, what was ultimately the final hard point in the series, 250-163. London Docks, it's an interesting one, because for quite some time, it was considered to be one of Envy's best maps, right? You look statistically throughout the year, Joe, it's been one where you would heavily favor Envy, but the past couple of weeks, it's... not gone well outside of what? Slasher dropping 55? If that's what it takes now to win that map of your Envy, is it time to go back to
their 1-6 or something?
In the past 2 weeks, they were like something ridiculous, like 11-1 before that. Like going to Atlanta, that was like their bread and butter map. But since then, they've kind of fallen apart on it.
Yeah, but I think to sort of against that Epsilon, that is one they've just played so many times. Like even when they were losing their first couple of weeks, they continued to choose London Dosh. And I mean, we criticized him on the decks. Like, why are you going to play that map if you're not slaying like the correct ways? But Dave has a great map, and it seems all those repetitions have helped them. They're able to put Envy away.
Yep. First game in the books. Congratulations, Epsilon. They get their second win for Envy. The loss doesn't really mean too much. That third spot, of course, still set in stone, and they're guaranteed that spot at playoffs, more importantly.